Hey everyone, it's been a while since I posted a video, but I really wanted to show you something, so follow me. If you haven't seen Netflix's new series, Stranger Things, you really should. It's the fantastic brainchild of the Duffer Brothers. Set in the 80s, it's packed with great characters and some solid horror and suspense. But nothing was as scary as what I spied hanging on a classroom wall in the final episode. I want to reiterate that I really loved Stranger Things. It didn't hurt that I saw a lot of my own 80s youth mirrored in the main characters. But that periodic table, maybe you didn't notice it, but I couldn't take my eyes off it. The Duffer Brothers might as well have thrown a Rogue One poster and slapped a Trump bumper sticker on top of it, because that periodic table had no business in 1983. It's an anachronism, a chronological inconsistency. Anachronisms wreak havoc on a viewer's willing suspension of disbelief. So how bad is this periodic table? Take a closer look. So when an element gets discovered, it's given a temporary designation based off its atomic number. You can easily spot them because the symbols have three letters. An element only gets an official name and symbol after the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, or the IUPAC, validates the discovery. And that's not always as easy as it sounds. Take a look at elements 114 and 116. They didn't get the official names of Flyrovium and Livermorium until 2012, almost 30 years after the events of Season 1. That's a big anachronism. And then, a giant curiosity door opened in front of me. What should a periodic table hanging up in a 1983 classroom have looked like? So by looking up the dates of discovery, we can quickly see that 10 elements weren't even discovered in 1983, so those can get pitched right away. Element 109 is named Meitnerium, in tribute to Lise Meitner, who most would argue was unjustly excluded from sharing the 1944 Nobel Prize in Chemistry for the discovery of the fission of heavy atomic nuclei. So if Mr. Clark had the newest periodic table available to him, it might have been there, most likely with the placeholder designation of unalunium. Element 106 and 107 would also probably be there, but also with temporary designations. The names Seaborgium and Borium wouldn't be made official till 1997, and the discovery of these elements were strongly contested by the Russians. Hey, it wouldn't be the 80s without some superpower conflicts. And that conflict is perfectly encapsulated in element 105. We know it as Dubnium, named in tribute of the Russian town of its discovery, but the Americans contested the discovery and weren't about to let some commies slap a Russian town on our periodic table. An American periodic table in 1983 would have called it Honium, after the daring smuggler who stole our hearts. No, just kidding. Honium is in the German chemist Otto Hahn. Remember Lise Meitner? Hahn won the Nobel Prize that many people thought Meitner should have shared. Hey, as Mr. Clark said, science is neat, but I'm afraid it's not very forgiving. To wrap it up, elements 102, 103, and 104, though not officially named until the 90s, were around long enough under those names that Mr. Clark's periodic table would match our own. So there you go. As best as I can tell, this is what a periodic table from 1983 would look like. I could not find a periodic table from 1983, but if anyone has an old textbook sitting around, let me know how close I got in the comments. And Duffer Brothers, if you're watching, I formally offer my assistance for any chronologically appropriate periodic tables that may be needed for Season 2. And oh yes, there is going to be a Season 2. And interestingly, the Season 1 periodic table itself will probably be outdated by Season 2. What do I mean by that? The IUPAC is set to formally recognize four more elements by the end of 2016. So say hello to Nihonium, Moscovium, Tennessine, and Ogansian, respectively. By the way, like Chief Hooper, sometimes I never know when to leave well enough alone. I did a little digging at my public library's microfiche room, and I think I might have actually found where they got the periodic table to use in the show. If you're at all interested in that, pop over to my new website and I'll show you what I found. Well, this was a lot of fun. Fans of my old videos, I hope you like the new format. I know you probably missed the old channel name as much as I do, but Guillotined 18th Century Chemist Theater, that was a bit of a mouthful. New viewers, please subscribe and see what curiosity door I duck through next time. Thanks for watching and have a great day.